Welcome to day 5 of Sleep Week. Today we're talking about dreams. All week long we've been talking about sleep disruptions, sleep habits, raising our awareness around sleep and disrupted sleep. And today we're going to talk about dreams. I'm hearing from lots and lots and lots of people that you're having really intense dreams, really vivid dreams, bad dreams, and that can be really distressing, that can be really upsetting to your sleep, and it can be really upsetting to you as a person to have those dreams, those kinds of experiences. So I'm going to talk about that. And today I'm going to give you 10 tips about dreaming, about managing big, wild, weird dream experiences. Number one, everyone dreams. I know that you will hear people say that they don't dream. That's not true. Everyone dreams. Now, not everyone's dreams get encoded into memory, but everyone does dream. Number two, when you are dreaming, your nervous system is still active. So that means that if you are having a big and scary dream, your nervous system is releasing chemicals associated with that kind of fear. And so when you wake up, you may still have, you know, you may still have that kind of hangover, that kind of emotional experience. So when you're dreaming, you're having an emotional experience and your nervous system is responding to that. So I put one and two together because I think it's really important, because a lot of times I hear people say, I don't dream, therefore I'm not impacted by dreams. But that's not true. When you wake up in the morning and you find that your mood is weird, or you find that you maybe feel sad, or maybe you feel angry for no reason, it's very likely that you had dreams around those themes and that that has triggered those feelings inside of you. If you remember your dreams, it may make more sense to you, but if you don't think of yourself as dreaming, then you may not understand why you have those feelings. So it's really important to understand that you do dream and that your nervous system is responding to those dreams. And so you have you are impacted by those dreams. Number three, the function of dreams is to process unresolved thoughts and feelings during the day. And so if you have a lot of anxiety or a lot of overwhelming thoughts and feelings during the day, which you might be having a lot of these days, then your dreams are probably going to be more intense and more vivid. If you are having more intense and vivid dreams, it might be a signal to you that you are having more of an experience than you are aware of during the day. So sometimes people will tell me that they're doing fine, that they're not really struggling with anxiety, but they're having all of these dreams, and that's a sign to me that maybe there's more going on than they're actually aware of. Number four, dreams love to feed on the trifecta of terror. This is something that I talked about in a previous video, the thought errors of exaggeration, repetition, and absolutes. So go back and check out that video if you're interested in learning more about the trifecta of terror. But when your brain during the day is repeating negative thoughts, when the exaggerations of bad things, when the sort of absolutes of things never changing, when those things are happening during the day, the brain is feeding on those, and that's really contributing a lot to your dreams at night. So pay attention to the trifecta of terror during the day and see how that impacts your dreaming. Number five, dreams contain information. Now, it's not, dreams can't be interpreted the way that I think a lot of people wish that they could be, where you can get a book and be like, this means this. That's not really how dreams work, but each person's dream does mean something. There is significance in there. The significance could be that you're dreaming about a thing you saw on TV. That is a significance. It also could be that you're dreaming about themes that are more important. Those can show up in obvious ways and not so obvious ways. So a really common one for people that have anxiety, have really bad anxiety, is dreams about teeth falling out. People will tell me about dreams about being chased, about falling, dreams where they find out or they see that their loved ones are being harmed or die. These are common themes, and they often center around anxiety, fear, lack of control, a sense of disempowerment, a sense of lowered self-esteem. A lot of the things that we're facing right now in terms of the pandemic are the things that can show up topically in dreams that are pretty common. So when you're dreaming, look for the themes rather than trying to say, like, what does it mean that there was a red flower in my dream? Look at your dreams overall and try to find what kind of themes might be emerging. I feel like if you feel like you're being chased all the time, that may mean that you aren't feeling safe. If you feel like you're falling all the time, that may mean you feel really ungrounded, and adding in more routine or adding in more stability to your day might help with that. So look for themes in your dreams. It's got information in it. If you resist that information, if you resist those ideas that are coming up in your dreams, they're gonna come up more. They're gonna come up in different ways. The things that you keep inside of you are trying to work their way out. And if you give them an appropriate outlet, then okay, if you don't, they're going to show up in ways that are really uncomfortable to you and to the people around you. Number six. So like I said in number two, your nervous system is still working when you're dreaming. So number six is where I want to talk about emotional hangovers. When you wake up, when you have these feelings, they can carry out throughout the day. You know, when you, if you think about when you have a big experience, when you're awake, if something bad happens and you have fear or you have sadness or you have one of those big feelings, you know that even once you're through that moment, like even into that evening and sometimes in the next day, you're still kind of carrying that icky feeling. That's because of the way that the limbic system processes information and processes feelings chemically. So if that's happening to you while you're dreaming, you may have an emotional hangover the next day. The reason that this is important to understand, one, is because reducing confusion about that can be really helpful. It can be really hard to have those feelings and be like, what? I went to bed and I was fine and now I'm waking up and having all these feelings, probably from dreams. But also because if you can work on shifting your dreaming, and I'm gonna mention that in just a second, when you work on shifting your dreaming, you can create maybe some of those positive experiences so that your limbic system is releasing chemicals associated with joy and hopefulness and success and those good things that you're looking for rather than that fear and anxiety. Number seven is associated with what I was just talking about in six, and that is the idea of dream setting. So dream setting is what I call it when right before you go to bed, you decide what you're going to dream about. Now, this is something that has been around as long as, you know, we have literature and documentation and of history. We know that people have worked to try to control dreaming. And we know that a lot of the greatest thinkers and the greatest inventors throughout history have said that they often solve problems while dreaming. So Einstein said that he would often think on a problem that he couldn't figure out and he would go to sleep and then he would wake up knowing the answer. The brain is still working. The brain is processing things. And so, you know, in some of the earlier videos this week during Sleep Week, we've talked about what are you putting in the bucket? You know, your little file clerks that are filing away all your thoughts and feelings during the week, I mean, during the day, are doing that work. But whatever's on top of that bucket is what they're dealing with first. And so if you're going to sleep and you're thinking about money and you're thinking about your family and you're thinking about viruses and you're thinking about work and you're thinking about all this, that's really what's going to kind of be the feeding the dream cycle. But if right before you go to sleep, you can say, you know, I think about something wonderful that's happened in your life, or thinking about something you're excited about, or thinking about something that you're planning for the future, that might start showing up in your dreams. And that then would release the limbic system chemicals and that would help you stay asleep and get you better sleep. And so give it a shot. If you're having big, intense, vivid dreams right before you're falling asleep, focus on what you want to dream about and see how that works. Number eight, you have to control your sleep schedule. When you sleep too much, you get too much REM sleep, you're gonna have a lot of dreams. And when you have too much space for dreaming, when you have too much REM cycle, then, you know, anxiety is just gonna invent things to be anxious about. And so it's just gonna add more unnecessary things to your dream pile. So you want to make sure that you're getting the right amount of sleep, the right amount of REM sleep. So make sure that you're keeping to a sleep schedule, that you're staying within the bounds of good sleep time. Number nine, when you wake up from a dream and you don't feel well, use imagery, use actions and experiences to reorient yourself. So let's say that you have an emotional hangover that's uncomfortable, go ahead and do something good. And if that means that you have to postpone your day for a little bit, or that means that you have to change your plans because you need to do something nice for yourself, that's okay. That's allowed. You know, we talked about the limbic system setting off all of those chemicals while you're sleeping. Doing something that does kind of elicit those good chemicals from the limbic system can kind of override what happened while you were sleeping. So when you wake up icky, you feel like you woke up on the wrong side of the bed, do something nice for yourself. Have ice cream for breakfast. I don't know, go swimming. Do something good for yourself and try to reorient your feelings in the morning. And number 10, if you are having a lot of bad dreams, it's time for therapy. That means, you know, I started with this, your dreams mean something. They contain information. And if you're not having the space or the ability, sometimes we don't have the ability to hold all of our big feelings and look at them objectively. You know, that would be nice, right? If we could just like crack our head open and be like, oh, I see what's happening in there. But we can't. And so we go to therapy instead. And that is when we crack our head open and pour all of our stuff out and somebody else sits across from us and says, this might be this. And therapists can help you pick out themes, can help you address those themes and come up with ways to handle that to reduce those bad dreams or those nightmares. So those are my top 10 tips for dreaming. Hopefully that helps. If you have thoughts or comments, would love to hear it as always. You can find me at drkarenmcdowell.com. /askme if you want to send in requests for videos or anything like that. Also Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and you can email me, thegraciousmind@gmail.com. Hope you had an excellent week. I hope that Sleep Week has been helpful for you. If you have ideas for other themes for weeks, I'd love to hear that because I definitely want to make content that is meaningful to you. So let me know what you think.